All right. Reading Rainbow, episode 9, 3 days on a river in a red canoe. I was the one who first noticed the red canoe for sale in a yard on the way home from school. My mom and my Aunt Rosie and my cousin Sam and I put our money together and bought it. The people who sold it to us threw in 2 paddles and 2 big old life jackets. As soon as we got home with the canoe, Aunt Rosie and Mom took out their maps, the canoe trips they had taken before Sam or I was even born were marked in colors. They found a 3-day trip that could be just right for us. Then we made lists of what we needed. Then we went shopping. Here are Sam and I in the store in new life jackets. They cost a lot, but Aunt Rosie and Mom agreed we had to have them, and an extra paddle and 20 feet of new rope. We also bought some packages of freeze-dried chicken and some dried apricots. Here is everything we need for the trip. The food is packed tight in waterproof sacks. My cat Six Toes is sitting on a sleeping bag. I wanted to take him, but Mom says a canoe is no place for a cat. I promised Six Toes to bring him back a fish. Next to my shoes and Sam's shoes are new pocket knives. We never even noticed Aunt Rosie buying them for us in the store today. Here we are on our way early in the morning. We drove and 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 drove. And drove and drove, and drove and drove, and drove and drove, and drove and drove, and drove and drove. We drove and drove. We drove all day. Now we are at the place Aunt Rosie and Mom had chosen for our first camp. We start on the river in the morning. Sam and I unloaded the car. Mom and Aunt Rosie put up the tent. We hurried to get inside before it got too dark, and the mosquitoes took too many bites out of us. We lay in our tent, listening to the river. When I poked my head out in the morning, everything was wet. Yet it wasn't even raining. We couldn't see our car. We could hardly see the river. We carried our canoe down to the water anyway. Here we are, setting out for a small island. It shows on the map. We've packed all our things into the canoe. We are going to fix our breakfast on the island when the sun warms up the river and dries up the mist. This is where we come out of the mist. I try paddling. Sam tries paddling. I am making the first fire of the trip. We find crayfish. We eat our lunch on top of this cliff. It's an apartment house for swallows. A good swimming hole. We get to the bottom fast. Here are Mom and Aunt Rosie paddling into a part of the river like a hot green tunnel. I fell asleep. I think Sam did too. It's good Mom and Rosie did. Right here is where they heard the roaring of the waterfall, but they had been listening for it. It was marked on their maps. Here I am looking over the edge. Aunt Rosie and Mom are lowering the canoe by ropes down over the waterfall. Sam and I climb up and down until we have carried all the gear to the bottom. We are going to camp here even though it's still early. Here's our shower. This is our kitchen. Aunt Rosie is the cook tonight. We are going to try the crayfish we caught along with our kitchen and rice. For dessert, Aunt Rosie showed us how to cook fruit stew and dumplings. This is the sink. You can stand right in it. The rocks make all the shelves and drain boards you need. We use the sand as scoring powder. Mom shows us some knots we can use to tie up the canoe. and in putting up the tent. Sam and I put up the tent by ourselves. Aunt Rosie told me to use the back of the axe head. Sam used a rock. It's hard to get the pegs in tight so they don't pull out. You have to pull the cords tight, too, so the tent won't be like an old balloon. This is an extra rope called a fly. And you have to tie a kind of knot you can untie easily. The tent cloth has to let in air, so it by itself it can't be waterproof. After supper, we build up our fire and sit beside it. Mom tells us stories about the animals that like the nighttime. We watch the stars and the sparks of our fire going up to join them. Sam isn't much of a weather predictor, but the rain didn't bother us. We put up the tent so well, hardly a drop of water came through. In the morning, we sat up in our sleeping bags and ate crackers and raisins. Aunt Rosie made cocoa on the little camping stove. We sat out on the river with all our things, even though it was pouring rain. I am shaking my paddle at the sky and yelling. Suddenly, as we came around this bend in the river, the sun came out through a hole in the clouds. A big rainbow spread across the sky. The rainbow faded away, and fish started to jump all around us. We got the fishing lines baited and into the water. Sam caught the first fish. Then I caught one. Then Aunt Rosie caught two in a row. Afterward, we spread out our things to dry on a sandy beach. What Mom and Aunt Rosie like to do best is take the canoe through fast-moving water. They can follow all the curves of the current. In the afternoon, we canoe without stopping. Sam and I paddle too. We came to a place where the rivers spread out through a meadow. Grass grows right out of the water, and we canoed in the grass. It came up over our heads and hit us. Aunt Rosie put her hand over my mouth so I wouldn't frighten away the moose and her calf. I wouldn't frighten away the moose and her calf. But even so, when they got wind of us, they ran right back into the woods. When we discovered this island, we all agreed it was the place to spend our third night. We planned to sleep right out under those trees. The tent is up just in case of rain. The Big Dipper is out. The Milky Way is spread right across the sky. There isn't one mosquito because of the breeze. That breeze turned into a wild wind in the middle of the night. Mom says it was almost hurricane strength. We caught the tent and the canoe just before the wind carried them off down the river. We did lose one pot and one up. We spent the rest of the night curled up in the bushes. The branches creaked and whooshed all night long. In the morning, we can't believe this is the same river. It's so still. Twigs and leaves and flowers float around us as we start our last day on the river. We watch a muskrat swimming. A heron dives for a fish. We feed crumbs to the ducks. Cows watch us having a river visit. We canoe through a town. We come to a low stone bridge. Sam gets excited. He stands up to wave. Mom yells, "Sit down!" I reach over and pull him down. Aunt Rosie and Mom race hard on the other side. This keeps our canoe and everything in it from turning over. But Sam ends up in the water. He swims to the rope and Rosie throws out to him and we tow him to shore. Mom doesn't say much, but she looks upset. Aunt Rosie looks scared. Sam changes to dry clothes and we canoe on. Just past the train bridge, Aunt Rosie asks Sam to stand up and see what's ahead. He gets up as though the canoe were a baby's cradle. He reports that the river is ending in a big lake. He says it looks like the edge of the world on the other side. Aunt Rosie says that's because we're coming to the town dam. Mom points the canoe to cross the lake. There's no current and the wind is against us. I'm glad it's slow going. When we get to the other side, our trip will be over. And here we are, taking our canoe out onto the bank. Aunt Rosie showed me on the map where the river goes from here. She says it travels on through rocky places with lots of rapids. Someday, after lots of practice, we can go there. But now we must catch a fish for my cat Six Toes. And Aunt Rosie is going to talk with other campers and find a lift back to our car, Ladybug, so we can get home tonight. Mom says canoeing back up the river against the current would be very, very hard even if we had time. Way past midnight, we turn into our own street. One by one, we stumble into the house. I go to sleep to the sound of Six Toes chewing on his fish. It seems I can still hear the sound of the river running over the rocks. The end.